jealous though, because look, if I had a voucher, I would definitely purchase a home with my voucher in collaboration with the NACA program if I was eligible to. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Thank y'all so much for clicking on this video. I have truly missed y'all. I have missed this whole setup, sitting in front of the camera, making these videos, talking to you guys, sharing good information to you guys about the NACA program, and not just the NACA program, but other information that I feel that you guys need to know about. So if you are interested in watching more of this video, then make sure you keep on watching. So I've been gone for a couple months and I just needed to take a break, because you know, with going back into the office, I kind of had to get readjusted to everything, and it was just a little bit too much for me trying to make videos and working at the same time and then my personal life. So I'm back and I wanted to be able to start sharing more content with you guys pertaining to buying a home using the NACA program and other programs that are available for you guys to use if you choose to. So we all know that there are more first-time home buyer programs that are available to you, and you do not necessarily have to use the NACA program. But before we get into this video, if you have not yet subscribed, please go down below and hit that red subscribe button, and also give me a thumbs up if you enjoy my content as well. That really helps out my channel to get it out to other people who are looking for this type of content. But yes, so just some quick updates for this channel. So I will continue to make NACA videos, but I'm also going to be soon to offer memberships for this channel, where if you decide to, I guess, sign up for the membership, you will have full access to all of my NACA videos that I make. Also, if you have questions pertaining to NACA that I can answer, I will be available to answer those questions if you sign up for the membership program. Now, that's not to say that if you choose to not sign up for the membership program, I'm not going to answer your questions, but those who are a member of this channel will have full access, will have first dibs, and I will be able to respond to your questions and, you know, just give you advice on my NACA journey, what I went through, and tips and tricks on how you can navigate your way using the NACA program. Also, I want to let you guys know that I will be doing more content based upon lifestyle, because this is a lifestyle channel. So I'm going to be doing more content like shop with me videos, decorating videos, clean with me videos, different things to that nature, because I don't want to limit myself on the kind of content that I make, because I enjoy making and doing all of those things. So I hope that you are interested in all of those different things, and I will have more information on the membership soon to come. All right, so the first thing that I wanted to talk about is some updates that NACA has provided to all of its members, and this just didn't recently happen. NACA did this a little bit back in, I want to say around March, April, and they completely revamped the website as far as the members and to access the member portal. So it's now called the member portal. And what you do is you go log in, and it's completely different from what I have ever been used to. And I believe that this is going to be great for those who don't really know how to operate a computer or upload documents. So it's supposed to be considered user-friendly. And based upon what I've heard and talked to a representative at NACA, a lot of people have found that this member portal has been easier for everyone to access and understand and upload documents. So it's supposed to allow the member to be able to upload documents more easily, and it's more accessible and user-friendly, and so it allows the process to move smoothly. And also, it will speed up the process. So whenever you submit documents, it goes directly into your portal, your account, your your file, your NACA mortgage counselor will be able to access those documents more easily and be able to speed up the process of allowing you to know exactly where you stand and what are the next steps. So that is really the only update that I have. And keep in mind that I closed on my home 2 years ago in 2020 of April. So I no longer have access to the member portal like you guys who are still going through the NACA process. When I logged in, the only thing that it told me was that my status said closed and that it said post buyer information or something to that nature. But when I clicked on the link, it didn't do anything because currently I don't have any appointments scheduled. So it won't allow me to access all the previous information that I was able to access before they did all the changes to the website. So if you guys know of any other changes and updates that NACA has provided to you all, please let me know down in the comments just so I can keep up with the updated NACA member portal. All right, so some other things that I wanted to talk to you guys about that you may already know about, but if you don't know, NACA is an advocacy program. They are just not here to help you buy a home. NACA is an advocacy program. And so NACA advocates on behalf of their members and behalf of the community. They are a nonprofit organization that gears towards advocacy and home buyers. They also provide home ownership to those who are eligible to participate in the program. And 9 times out of 10, if you are working and you have worked for at least 2 years, you've been making on-time rental payments for at least 12 to 24 months, you are technically eligible to apply for the NACA program besides the other requirements that your mortgage counselor would tell you about. So NACA is more than just a home buyer program. They do so much more for the community. And that is one of the reasons why I decided to sign up with the NACA program and use them. Me and my husband did not have to use NACA because of our income. We made more than enough money to go the traditional route, but because of all the benefits that NACA has to offer, we wanted to use NACA because we wanted to get the most out of the first time ever buying a home. And so we decided to use the NACA program. So if you haven't already decided on what program that you want to use and you've been thinking about NACA and you want to know more information, I suggest going to NACA's website. NACA will be able to tell you everything about it on their website. They have Q&As where if you have a specific question that you don't know the answer to and you just cannot find it, whether it's here on YouTube or Google, I'm definitely sure NACA will have the answer for you on their website. And then you can also ask me. Like I said, I went through the program. I bought my home 2 years ago, decided to buy a new construction home. So if you have any questions about that, you can always leave me a comment down below and I will respond to you. All right, so the last thing that I want to talk about in today's video, so this is kind of like, it might be all over the place, but you know, this is my first NACA video after a few months, and who cares if it's all over the place? It is providing some great information to you guys, and if it is all over the place, then oh well. All right, so the last thing that I want to talk about is called the HOPFA program, which is through the NACA program. And I have discussed this, I believe, once or twice before on my channel, but I want to let you guys know about it again. Because if y'all don't know anything about the HOPFA program that NACA has, you need to look into it. I promise you, you will be amazed and you will be like, oh, I need to jump on that, because it is definitely a great program if you have this one particular thing. All right, and that one particular thing is called an HCV, which stands for Housing Choice Voucher. So if you have a Housing Choice Voucher, that means that you are a recipient of Section 8. And with that, you are eligible to participate in NACA's HOPFA program. But there are other stipulations that come with this program. So wherever you are, whatever state, whatever city, whatever county you are in, your public housing authority has to be participating, and this program where it allows them to collaborate with NACA. So if your public housing authority is not in collaboration or does not choose to collaborate with the NACA program, then you may not be able to use your voucher to purchase a home in conjunction with the NACA program. So if you are interested in purchasing your home with your HCV voucher with NACA, then I would suggest talking to your mortgage counselor and also talking to your PHA, which is the Public Housing Authority, to see if they are willing to participate with the NACA program. That way you can get the most out of buying your home. And to be honest, it is probably one of the best ways to buy a home because you are eligible to buy your home in half the time as a regular person who is just going through the NACA program and does not have a voucher. Instead of you purchasing your home within 30 years, which is the typical time period that a person would purchase their home through, which is the 30-year program or the 30-year term, you would be able to purchase your home within the 15-year term and cut that time in half if you have an HCV voucher. So I would definitely recommend talking to your public housing authority and also talking to your mortgage counselor to see if you are eligible to purchase your home using your voucher. But to be honest, it is definitely so beneficial and rewarding to have a voucher. And a lot of people look down on those who have a voucher. But it's nothing to hide that you are a recipient of the Housing Choice Voucher Program because it has so many benefits that you will be able to use once you find out from your PHA or the NACA program. And not all PHAs are willing to collaborate with the NACA program because they have their own programs within their housing authority. Some housing authorities have the home ownership program, which is also called the Family Self-Sufficiency Program. So they choose not to collaborate with the NACA program because they have their own home ownership programs. But for some PHAs, they may not have their program, which is the Family Self-Sufficiency Program, open. It may be closed. And so you may want to check with them to see if they're willing to collaborate with the NACA program just to see if you could purchase your home using your voucher in conjunction with the NACA program. So that is really all that I have for you guys today. I wanted to come back and let you know that all is well. I'm back making videos. I don't know exactly how often per week that I will drop a video, but if you will go ahead and subscribe to this YouTube channel and turn on your notification bell so when I do drop a video, you do not miss it. Make sure to give me a thumbs up and always leave me a comment if you have questions about the NACA program, about my journey going through the NACA program, and also if you have questions about the HOTFOR program or if you have participated in NACA's HOTFOR program, then let me know down below. And you can only participate in the HOTFOR program if you have an HCV voucher. Otherwise, you are not eligible for NACA's HOTFOR program. Please make sure to, like I said, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. And in my next video, I'm going to go a little bit more into detail with the NACA program about the HCV HOTFOR program that you guys can try to sign up for and use. I hope that you guys enjoyed today's video. I truly enjoyed making this video today. It felt so good to be back. And so I will see you guys in the next video.